Well, a good evening to you catching the show right now from your comfort zone, from your workplace, from everywhere you might be, you know, probably on the street, or you're going to the salon to, you know, trim your hair, or you're in the salon to plait your hair. Whatever it is that you're doing, you're tuned in to Skizzy with me, the main man, the King, Siobhan Malcolm. Be a part of the show, not forgetting that is using your phone messages. Get it to your phone message, type Skizzy, let it space your message and send it to 8338. And also, you can also be a part of the show by getting onto Twitter. The trend is hashtag. That is a Skizzy UG, and on Facebook, which happens to be Auburn Television. But well, my Facebook also happens to be King Siobhan Malcolm, and actually the show is brought to you by Airtel, not forgetting Coca-Cola. And at this point, I happen to be having someone on the show, and she was part of Tosca, that is a Project Femme season 6, the one just concluded, right? I think I'm right, yeah? And well, she's finally in the building. She has a couple of videos out already, and well, this time she was like, you know, I have a new video, and why not drop it fast on the King show? She goes by the name of Daisy. Daisy Ijang. Did I get the name right?
Yes, you did.
Yes, that's a great introduction, I would say. Well, yeah. Daisy Ijang is in the building, and if you were following, that is a Tosca Project fan.
Yeah.
She was there, the last one, right?
Exactly.
First, tell me, how does it feel, first of all, to be a man, the finalist for the time, you know, especially a man in the top two, or to be top, you know, second?
Yeah, it's at that point, it's a tiring experience because
it's a long way.
It's a long way, so you're so tired. But after coming out, I think it's a privilege, and the platform that it comes with it, just it's amazing. Yeah.
Well, it's amazing. Yeah. And talking about the platform, what did it help you as Tosca Project before you became, before you went to Tosca Project Femme? How did your life change?
Well, before I went for Tosca Project Femme, I was simply a young Daisy Hope. Uh-huh. But after coming out of Tosca Project Femme, I became Daisy Ijang.
Oh, so now there's two people here. Basically, that is Ijang Hope.
Yes, there's Ijang Daisy Hope, and then Daisy Ijang.
Daisy Ijang. So what made you change up the names or switch up the names?
Well, Ijang Daisy Hope is me, is the the home girl and everything, and Daisy Ijang is actually the artist.
Okay.
Exactly, which. It's what most people see out there. So, yeah. Well, Tosca Project Femme helped me see that.
Well, pretty interesting stuff. But well, you know, after you coming out of, Tosca, how things been going on for you? So far, you told me you have four, videos that you already have that are out. Mm-hmm. Tell me how things going on as a musician right now, life of a musician.
Well, it's quite challenging. I won't say it's easy. It's very challenging. And being that I am doing music that I love to do and not just music for the market. So it becomes...
Music that you love to do.
Yes, I love to do. And it's not just for the market.
Yes.
So it gets a bit challenging sometimes because some people will not relate to it, or you'll find criticism here and there. But it's been amazing so far.
It's been an amazing challenge.
Yes, it has.
Well, did you ever see yourself probably 4 years from now, actually 4 years back, to be what you are today?
I have always seen myself becoming one of the biggest artists in the world.
The biggest artist in
the world. Ever since I was 7 years. So for me, I have not yet reached. I am not
You're
even
still
yet.
Grown,
I'm still a baby in this thing, and I hope to take it so far.
Yeah, definitely, you're a baby. If we're talking about Madonna being in the game for what?
32 years. Oh my god.
That's only her music. Yeah. Her music career is 32 years. So
it's crazy.
You're probably not even 30. You know,
maybe I'm not even born. You know.
So she's been doing it. But well, basically, as you know, you're going on as Daisy Ijang. You know, what should we expect for 2015 for artists like Daisy Ijang? You know. What should we expect 2015?
Well, 2015 has a lot of packed things in it. Yeah. There is so much in store that if I start to break it down, we might sleep here. Mm. But we have videos coming out. I've gotten signed to a beautiful label in Kenya. So it's going to be great. I can speak. I want the words to speak for it.
Yeah. Well, that is pretty amazing stuff. That is actually, this is a new video, right? This is part of the new video that you're getting to see right now.
Yeah.
And I would say, well, it's pretty interesting. I like the shooting. Who did the shooting of the video?
Gopa DJs.
Oh, Gopa
from
DJs.
Yeah, though we had to go
are
to
they, Are they saying? No. What was the song? I'm forgetting the song. Way back in early 2000s. Are they the guys who did that song? That's all still the same.
Exactly.
Basically, click. And beautiful stuff going on. That's part of the video. What makes you choose, have this type of setting for the video? Is it you who chose it, or the GoPro guys said, let's make a video this way?
No, I actually, most of the times when we're shooting a video, when I'm writing a song, I have a script in my head that I'm already saying. So basically, this is This is what I was seeing in my head. Yeah. And being that I am partly a Karamojong and a Langi, I wanted to fuse in that culture a bit, you know. So
I like that. That is authenticity there, you know. Someone, you know, getting back to the roots and wanting to represent something way back, exactly. You know, home. Yeah. That is pretty good stuff, right?
Thank you.
And, well, actually, I've been told you happen to be having an album. Is it dropping this year?
Oh, yes. Year? Oh, yeah. This year we are dropping an album. I have great management, by the way. Shout out to Mr. DJ Krim and my personal PA, Fiona Katushabe. These guys are amazing. So we are working so hard to make sure that this year you will have an album.
DJ Krim is your manager. that's weird, you know. I never seen, you know, that is you know, these, you know, leadership qualities in him.
Oh my gosh, no. Honestly, I don't think you know him. You know, it was actually amazing. It was Fat Side looking at each other and there was a connection.
Oh, there was a connection. Not a love connection, but a working relationship.
You never know.
You never know. Okay, listen, so if you got out there and you're probably into DJ Krim, better watch out.
No. I'm just joking.
Well, interesting stuff going on right now. But well, thanks for coming to the show.
Thank you.
Before we get down with this one, I want you to have a time for yourself. Get to introduce your new video, which is called Sweetie, right?
Yes.
And you know, before we actually, what's Sweetie about? Sweetie, love?
Yes, Sweetie, love.
Sweetie.
Exactly.
Honey, like the way
you honey, like, you know, the love of your life. Yeah, like those things. I'm just hoping it's a dedication to my future husband who I've not yet met. But yeah.
That's amazing. Look into a camera right now and get to, you know, get into your video, introduce your video for 2015 as we get into it.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Daisy Ajang one more time. Thank you so much for the love. And this is our new single for 2015. Sweetie, enjoy.
Well, check it out. You're still tuning in to Auburn TV. Skiz is the name of the show. We meet the main man, the King Siobhan Malcolm, brought to you by Airtel, not forgetting Coca-Cola. Stay tuned, we'll be back. Well, coming in, that's a massive tune. Well, all of that is up from Daisy Ajang.